Hi, everyone. I'm Harry Chikma here with a veteran from the Boston Lobsters, Eric Budorak. You're joining the team yet again, coming back to the Ferncroft Country Club. Eric, what do you like so much about playing for Boston?
Well, Boston's my hometown now. It's where I live. So for me, playing in my backyard in front of my friends and family with the team that I played at now 3 years in a row, I'm really excited to be back, and I think it's hopefully going to be another great year.
And you've made Boston home for yourself now, so you obviously love the city. I mean, what is it about that city and being part of one of the richest sports franchises, so to speak, with Boston? What is it about that area that you love so much?
Well, the people in Boston, they love sports. They love all sports. They're into the Celtics, the Red Sox. And I think now that we've had a couple really good, successful world team tennis seasons, people are starting to take notice of the Lobsters, too.
Do you ever feel the pressure, though, playing there in Boston? I mean, you have rivalries with the New York Sport Times. It's almost like the Red Sox versus Yankees vying for those playoff spots. I mean, what's that pressure like?
Yeah, there is some pressure. I actually lost a match with a match point going both ways to New York 2 years ago at home, and it was a tough one to swallow. So, I mean, it's why you practice. It's why you put so much time in to go out there and perform in front of all the people that you know and hopefully get wins for them.
In the last 2 years, you guys have made the semifinals. You're trying to break through and make that final and hopefully win the World Team Tennis Championship. What's it going to take to do that?
Well, I think we got a great team coming back. I mean, with myself and Jan Michael, we've been pretty strong on the men's side. And then this year, bringing in Irina Falcone, who played for us last year, a top 100 woman. I think she's going to be a huge asset for us. And then a great doubles and mixed doubles player in Carly Gullickson. I think we really have the right team formula. It's just a matter of whether we can get it done.
What do you like so much about Bud Schultz? I know he's helped you as a coach, as a person. How do you like Bud?
Bud's one of the best coaches around. I use him as a coach even when I'm on the tour, not just in World Team Tennis. He's got great experience because he was on the tour himself, and just a really good calming influence as well. Sometimes you get a little too amped up out there, and to have a coach who really puts everything in perspective and can kind of keep you on the right path, he's really helped us out.
Kids going for their dreams like you. You played Division III tennis, and now you're one of the best players in the world. You've had great wins, seeded in Grand Slams. What would you tell a kid who is going for his dream?
Just make sure you enjoy it. I mean, you never really know how far you're going to get. When I first went out on the tour, I just thought, you know, I'm going to give it my best. I'm going to keep playing until I feel like I've reached, you know, my top level. And here I am, you know, 9 years later on the pro tour, you know, still working hard, still doing my best, and really trying to embrace and enjoy every second of it.
What are your goals moving forward?
You know, just keep trying to improve my game. I spent a lot of years now in the top, you know, 30, 40 in the world. I'd love to get myself into that kind of top 10 echelon of teams. Ideally win a Grand Slam someday, but you know, those are just results. I'm all about just trying to really kind of, you know, become the best that I can be.
Well, congratulations. I know you got married recently as well, so it's good to see you doing well on and off the court.
Life's good, man.
Great. Eric Budorak with the Boston Lobsters ready for another year. Harry Chikma with Eric. We'll be right back on this Boston Lobsters broadcast.